cell notation of C1. Okay? Suppose the reaction is this. 280 plus aqueous. Assume concentration as C1 or something. Plus H2 gas we have. Then we have 2H plus aqueous plus 2AG solid. This is the reaction given. You have to write down the cell notation. The reaction of anode is what?
H2,
right? So we'll write H2. We'll write down the reaction of anode. H2 gas gives 2H plus plus 2 electrons. And cathode reaction is what? 2AG plus aqueous plus 2 electron gives 2AG. Right. However, this is not required here. So we have a salt bridge. Right. The anode cathode reaction is not required. Just we need to identify. Okay. This is anode and cathode is cathode. Partial pressure we have to mention. Okay. H2 is converting into H plus, right? So we'll write H2 gas converts into H plus C1 molar, suppose the concentration I was. Okay? And here we have to mention what? The pressure of it, right? So H2 pressure, suppose I am assuming P atmosphere. Okay, gas. After this, we have got AG plus is converting into AG. So we have AG plus concentration is suppose C2 molar. Then we have phase boundary, AG solid. Then we have what? G cell. This is the cell notation. But one important thing here, it is what? Since it is a gaseous substance, right? So for gaseous substance, we have to provide a surface where the reaction takes place. Right? So we have to introduce an inert electrode, and generally we use platinum. So whenever you have a gaseous substance, you have to add an inert electrode onto it so that at that surface the gas will react with the ions or the electrolyte. Okay? So whenever you have gaseous substance, you must have to add this any inert electrode, generally we use platinum. This is the cell notation of this. Right, this you must know. Understood? Right? So this is how we write down the cell notation of cell reaction. Now if cell notation is given, can you write down the cell reaction easily? So from cell notation, what you can conclude first of all? You have to write down the reaction of anode and cathode, and then you have to add both to get the net reaction. So whatever written on the left hand side, that will represent what? Anode. And this one is cathode. So one example of that also.
Yes.
H plus simply. It means the balanced reaction we don't write here. We'll just write down the atoms, ions, right? Okay. When you write down the reaction like this, then you have to write two. Okay. So one will see with cell notation how to write down the cell reaction. The cell notation is given here. The cell notation is this. AG solid. It's AG plus aqueous. Concentration not given, you can assume C1 to be. And then it gives Cu2 plus aqueous Cu solid E cell. We have to write down the cell reaction. Write down the reaction of anode, reaction of cathode, and then write on the then reaction. Done? information is given. Platinum Cl minus. Cl minus aqueous.
Why we are calculating, why we are calling it as relative standard electrode potential?
a half cell does not work alone, right? So if half cell does not work alone, we cannot find out the absolute value of that particular half cell, right? So we, what we do, we assume the half cell of one electrode, like electrode potential of one half cell, and that half cell is what? Hydrogen, standard hydrogen electrode. So what we assume, the standard electrode potential of SHE, SHE means what? Standard hydrogen electrode is zero, right? And with respect to that, we'll calculate the electrode potential of other half cell. Suppose you have to find out for copper, right? What we do, we'll take a copper half cell, we'll connect this with a voltmeter, and this side we have what? Hydrogen electrode, right? This is hydrogen, this is copper, right? So since we have assumed this for zero, so what is the EMF of the cell? E cell is what? E cathode minus E anode. E of copper minus E of hydrogen. So this deflection in this voltmeter gives you this E cell, right? So E cell you have, right? E of hydrogen is what? We have assumed zero, so we'll get the value of E of copper. Similarly, in this way only, we calculate the reduction potential of various electrodes, copper, zinc, iron, lithium, sodium, many other things, right? So we'll get a value of electrode potential for different electrodes. When we arrange this in ascending or descending order, we get a series. And that series we call it as what? Electrochemical series, correct? So we'll see why we call it as relative, because we are calculating the reduction potential of one electrode with respect to others. That's why it is a relative standard electrode, right? So the standard electrode that we are taking for this purpose is what? Standard hydrogen electrode, right? Right under this, since the half cell does not work alone, since the half cell does not work alone, hence we cannot calculate the absolute value of reduction potential for any electrode. Next slide. The reference electrode. The reference electrode for this purpose is standard hydrogen electrode. Standard hydrogen electrode.